Boom! I'm doing my best, people. Boom! Plop! Bums! Boobs! It's a porn explosion. I'm really trying. Now, note the light left on. That the detectives amongst you will know old miser Dangerfield would not leave a light on. You might be able to see. They can see in mirror. You might be able to see a naked lady in the mirror with no clothes on. There you go. Get some. So I have a visitor. Five. Oh God, that's what I actually look like, people. It ain't bad though, is it? Yeah, look. How's that? If you told me at 30 that I was going to look this good at 50, I'd have said, yeah, I reckon you're probably right. So I'm very excited. My girlfriend's here. And how wonderful. You know, in yesterday's video, I was talking about getting back to your life. You know, stay engaged with what's going on. Take some political responsibility. But get back to your life. And, you know, we've been together nearly 4 years. And my heart's going. And when she first came here, shaking with almost the same excitement of when we first got together. That's wonderful. Now, look, I don't expect that to last for 20, 30 years. Well, I don't expect myself to last for 20 or 30 years. But something's working there. Something's going right there. And I'll take it. I'll take that. And you know, I talk about acceptance and gratitude and, you know, and they're not passive things. You have to do them. Well, that is what that is. I'm having gratitude at the moment. I'm thinking that's a lovely thing. It's lovely to have someone in your life who you love, who you trust, who loves you, who trusts you. You know, I haven't had a lot of that in my life. And what a touch. And that gratitude just gives meaning to my life. And life without meaning is just struggle. What the fucking point? Why is it I know that most of the women are going, ah, oh, that's really sweet. And most of the men are just like, get on with it. I'm not here for this shit. This is the stuff I don't like. There, you look at DT as I said it. She's a tease. Let's face it, she's a tease, but you know, that's sexy stuff. Nice to see you, Broken Silence. How are you getting on, mate, by the way? Gaffney, what do you reckon? If you had to bet, I reckon 90% of viewers saw that. Very interesting. Well, I'm going to wait for a few more people to turn up before we get into that. I know it's the crack of dawn, not that dawn. There you go. Look, there you go. Hey, but Manny Moon knows it though. Look, boom. Grego's playing. Where's my vape? I can't function without, I couldn't even say function. I said punction. It's the name of my new band. I've got very little wrapped up. I've been so busy. I've already done 4 hours work. Oh, look at me. I've already done 4 hours work. So what? Imagine having the biggest sale of the year and no stock. Not because we didn't order it on time. This was ordered about 8 months ago. Yeah. No, it's coming. It's coming. It's coming. It's coming. It's coming. It's coming. The month before Black Friday, you better find a different supplier. That's all right, mate. It's all right. I'm not saving up for an house. Don't worry about it. I'm not trying to buy a new computer. Fuck you, life! And we've done gratitude. There is acceptance. I had a little crisis. I sat there thinking, I did everything right. I did everything right. And then I just thought, right, I'm going to give yourself 10 minutes. Wallow in it, boy. Wallow. So I wallowed. I was like, fucking, fuck, 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 fuck. Blamed staff, blamed myself, blamed the business partner, blamed the coof, blamed everything. And then at the end of that, I just went, okay, this has happened, and this is active acceptance. It's happened. This is where you are now. What can you do about it? What can you do about it? And that's what I've been doing. So there you are. That is our, that is what I mean by active gratitude, as I explained 5 minutes ago, and active acceptance. Doesn't make it right. Doesn't mean there aren't things that might could have been done better by me. And it doesn't mean that sometimes the universe would appear to be conspiring against you. But it just means, what can you do about it? And what can't you do about it? You know, I can't go back in time. So get busy, boy. Get off your ass, dust yourself down, stand up, be a warrior and get busy. Boom. Lovely. We've got loads of people in here. Absolutely loads of OG scrubs. Shush. I've got nothing prepared. Don't matter. Well, you know. Well, exactly, DT. You have to let go. You have to let go. Hello, DT. Hello, Aramas. Hello, Tito. Hello, Kajetal. Keys to the Kingdom's on the firm. Loki's in here. Gaffney. Aramas. Marwood. Linda. Manny Moo. Loads of people. Marzipan's here. Space Hopper Mark. I still haven't put that fucking video to that audio yet. Sorry, mate. I feel bad. Son of Max, Father of Plenty is on the firm. Broken Silence. Adjust collar. Steady. Loomy, loomy, loo. Where are you? We've got some things to do now. Liberty Alessia. Libby, John, it's so lovely to see you. I'm sorry. Hello, Skin Scar. Good to see you, mate. How are you? A song came on yesterday. It was actually in that crappy film, The Fence. But I heard it in The Fence. I think it's Bad Manners. But it might be the beat. Skin Scar, what is it? You'll know. Something like that. There's not a lot to go on, but I think you'll know. Hello, Plastic African. How are you? Warm Feet Winner is on the firm. Yeah, I think everyone in here is. ST911. I'll turn up, pretend to look busy, then go home and munch chocolate. Oh, that's on the back of you've got work in an hour. Don't worry, people. The stream will start in a minute. This is just a palaver. I'm just waiting for a few numbers to get here because the content is hot. I tell you what, talking about... Hello, Packer. Talking about... okay. Well, good luck with the MOT. I will just mention, Packer, that a certain Mosaic Labrador managed to not only listen to the stream, but appear on it whilst driving a fucking snowplow. You're taking a truck from an MOT and you can't listen. Yeah, that's the difference between two men right there. Nice one, Pack. I hope he goes down well at the MOT. Hello, Martin. Good to see you. You're looking very thoughtful in the thumbnail. Yeah, that's my thinking pose. And it is a pose too. Oh, where's Alan? No, Alan. Maybe he's grafted. Maybe it's too early in America. Telford Tees is on the firm. Toomey. Hello, mate. Hoyt to that. Mad Lizzie. Woodlander. Doc Shelley. Hello, Jemima Saliva. It is Bad Manners, is it? Or is it just bad manner to go, abba-doo-ba-dee-ba-da-da-boo? Is that what the song's called? Or are you just saying that? That's it. I even say it in the bloody... It's a selector, isn't it? I even say it in the review. Let me just check it out. We'll hear it. We'll have a bit of it. What a tune. Oh, yeah, because I'm on radio. It's selector, isn't it? I mention it in the damn review. Why didn't I even remember my own thing? I remember seeing it on Top of the Pops. Right, hang on. You should be able to hear this. Hang on. Let's have a bit of this. Cracking tune. Do like a bit of Scar. I wonder why I thought Skin Scar might have appreciated it. We can literally have about... Well, you're not allowed to have any, by the way. I found out about the 15-second rule. I'll tell you that in a minute, but check a bit of this out. I can remember this being on Top of the Pops and being about 10 and thinking, well, that's quite groovy. Check it. Oh, my God. That's so popping. There you go. What a tune. What a tune. I can remember watching it just thinking, wow. So, you know when I say, oh, you can only play 15 seconds? No, you can't play any copyrighted music. None. Now, that record company has now got a couple of choices because they'll get a bing copyright match and they'll get about 1,000 of them a day, really, because, you know, I think there's something like an hour of YouTube content uploaded every minute, right? That was my last time I looked, about 2 years ago. And so, you know, and people do that. They can choose to ban it from being seen. They can choose to monetize your video. I don't monetize my videos. You know, I'll do the grift in a minute, but I don't put adverts on them. And people say to me, yeah, but I've seen adverts on your video. Yeah, this is how cuntish it is. If I, because I used a bit of their music, they can now monetize my video. Nice. So I could talk for 7 hours, and they'd have adverts on it. Not ideal, but you know, there you go. Yeah, you'd hope not. I mean, how cool were they? That the I remember. First single I ever bought was A Message to You, Rudy, the Specials. And I bought it mainly for the black and white checks on the cover and the bloke with the little pork pie hat and the wraparounds. I just and his little lapels and tie. What a logo the two-tone logo was. Yeah, I think you're right, Broken Silence. I think they might cut a bit of slack. And it's weird because, you know, like I was telling you about Rick Beato saying that the Jimi Hendrix and the Led Zeppelin labels, they don't let anyone get away with anything. They block videos because that two-tone could choose to block this video later. They might say, no, you have to cut that section out. And the Hendrix estate and the Zeppelin estate do. Now, when you look at Spotify, you've got acts like Queen who've had like 100 billion downloads. And you go to Hendrix and it's like 5 million, which is nothing. That's nothing compared to the scale. Now, there's a problem with that because they want the money. No, you play our music, you have to pay us. Oh, that's all very well. But then people don't use your music in videos. People don't. Rick Beato doesn't do videos about Hendrix. In 30 years' time, you'll say to a teenager, you know, Jimi Hendrix, like one of the greatest and without a doubt, one of the most innovative guitar players of all time. And they'll be like, no, I never heard of him. Whereas when I was a teenager in the 80s, that's still 20 years after it happened, everyone knew Hendrix. But, you know, the greed of the record companies and basically the twisted marketing, you know, it's terrible marketing. I've left the bathroom light on. I don't like that. I do apologize for today's clamour. It is essentially a mini skirt. Sorry, but I don't expect to be up too much. Hello, Dimitri Jaborn. Nice to see you. Jay's is usually over on Twitch. There's 80 of us over on YouTube, but nice to see you. Ludwig says Mirror in the Bathroom was his first single. Mirror in the Bathroom. Bam, bam. But Hendrix wasn't as good as Mungo Jerry. Well, if you're going to release a song that says, have a drink, have a drive, go out and see what you can find. Have a drink, have a drive. Those were the days. Oh, no, do it. I like the tune, though. Please don't ruin the tune for me with some awful stuff. Right. How did your rock and roll go yesterday? Yeah. But it's terrible marketing. It's terrible marketing because no one gets to listen to it. and people won't know it. Old Rufus bought Ghost Town. It's a great tune, isn't it? Great tune. Right, we'll start the show in a minute. Mungo Jerry is still playing. With a face like that, you've got to do what you can do. Dimitri Bourne still loves Hendrix. Good, good. But I am talking about 30 years' time. Keys to the Kingdom can't wait. He can't wait for the doors of Griftation to be opened with a sesame seed bun. To all beef patties, special sauce, lettuce, cheese, pickles and onions, all wrapped up in a sesame seed bun. If you haven't heard the story before, McDonald's done a big promo in about 1980. And if you could say their tagline in under 2 seconds or something, you got a free Big Mac. If you could, and a badge saying I won the McDonald's the Big Mac challenge. If you didn't do it, you got a badge saying I failed the Big Mac challenge. So me and my brother go down there. Every kid in Dartford is in the queue for free food. I mean, that would have been the first burger they ate ever. In those days, you went to McDonald's for your birthdays. Seriously. There'll be people in the chat who will tell you now that McDonald's or Wimpy, more usually, because that was a bit sooner, you went there for your birthday. So free Big Mac. Right. So we've gone there. I've sat down and I've gone, right. And she said, are you ready? And I was thinking, oh, here we go. Free Big Mac. You know, my mum would never buy me a Big Mac. Even on my birthday, it was a burger, cheeseburger, if you're lucky, and a pack of chips. So I thought, an actual Big Mac. This is like, So I've gone, to all beef patties, special sauce, lettuce, cheese, pickles and onions, all wrapped up in a sesame seed bun. And she went, oh, sorry, love, you're a second and a half over. And I was like, this can't be right. Right? My brother sits down and he went, to all sesame seed bun. And she went, yay! And I was like, oh, I see. You have to cheat. I should have known. There I was trying to be a nice lad. Keys to the Kingdom. Thank you very much for that donation. Much appreciated. I'll get that. I'll get the doors of Griftation open right now. I've got that song in my head now. Da-da-do-da-da-da-da-da-da. You know, it was weird. I remember being 19, and thought, you know, I obviously knew everything. And I remember a geezer telling me that ska came before reggae. And I was like, don't be silly. And of course, I lost that argument. Yeah, very, very strange that ska. I think I've got it round the right way. I don't know anymore. I've got my new favorite YouTuber, and he is today's toxic masculinity section. And I've asked him to come on. Will he come on this channel? I don't know. He's got about the same amount of subscribers as me. He might. He looks bored. I won't tell him, but he reminds me a little bit of a young me, you know, precocious, unpleasant, arrogant, largely dislikable. Right, where are we? Right, thank you, Keys to the Kingdom. Really, really sweet of you. Much appreciated. right, here we go. All right there, you can become a... This is how you can support this channel. This is how you can oil the cogs of the machine that is the glorious House of Scrubs. You can become a member. That's the top link in the description. And we do private streams for members. And they're really good fun because we try and get as many people on the screen as possible. And it's a misanthrope and technical catastrophe. Really good fun. I've got to get the two heroes done this week. I will do. And actually, I've decided to do the two hero stream separately because if I do one, that's not actually as good, is it? That's just one longer. Better to have two. And if I do them at different times, more people might be able to get to them. Anyway, super chat like Keys to the Kingdom. That's the dollar sign at the bottom of the chat over there. There's the paying mantis showing you. Entropy, especially good because you don't give a penny to YouTube. I will pin the entropy link to the top of the YouTube chat. 1 second. They're coming in too fast. Boom. Ciao. I think you'll find the entropy link is up there. I don't expect to get rich from this hoo-ha, but I do put a lot of time, effort, passion, and research into this, Lark. So I do fully appreciate a few donations. And I have to say, you're a very generous bunch, and it works out nicely. Therefore, justify me to not be working on my day job and spending time here. Having said that, because the missus is here, probably won't be two streams a day. So this will probably be it for today. However, I spoke to her earlier and she seems to have quite a busy week. So if she goes out like in the evening, I'll do a stream. So you might get a couple. Just keep an eye on your notifications. Alternatively, follow my Telegram. That is the best place to be notified about anything I do. And I've been very busy on there lately, printing some very interesting stuff. Good lords, then. I remember Huckleberries. They came and went, didn't they? Very weird. Hello, what's the name over there on Twitch, Rooney? Hello, David. Good to see you, mate. Eunice is here. John, there's a dog in the house, Steve. Broken Silence says, Scar Reggae, Bluebeat, Rocksteady accents the off on the offbeat, but different pacing and emphasis of one and two. And this is what he means. So if it's one, two, three, four, one. So you get that instead of, so it's one, two, two. And that's why it sounds like that. A very particular sound. One, up, one, up, and at, and at, and at. Don't clip that. And at, and at, and at, and at, and at. Clip that. That's a better version. If you're going to be stupid. So I've had about five people talk to me. I can't believe you had Chris PT on your channel. He's mental. Really? Loads of people. And I was like, oh, okay. So what? He needs some help. No, abandon him. Abandon people who need help. Fuck them. Let them fall down the drain. Yeah, but he's done bad things. Okay, let's go through our whole community and find people who've done some bad things and get rid of them too. Who's left? Jesus and Buddha. Actually, no. Who would win in a fight between Jesu and Buddha? Strummer. Don't worry, people. The stream will start in a minute. It's called the skank. This is incredible. Absolutely. Hello, Steve. Hello, John. Shall we have a little look at the New Zealand? I mean, this is terrifying, and it is relevant to what I'm going to speak about today. Not for the old stream, because I never do that, but I am going to talk about the problem being the solution. I am going to talk about the seeds of the destruction of this current tyranny, being part of that tyranny, and I'm very serious about that. But check out the New Zealand premiere. Look at, watch, Sodom and Gomorrah is not the best place for a honeymoon. I'm going to show you this, the New Zealand PM, right? It's not necessarily what she says, because we've all heard this nonsense. But, I mean, if you want to see the hysteric face of tyranny, this is it. I mean, she's cracking up. Watch this and just go, oh, hello, Cecil. Nice to see you. Jesus was ripped from all that carpentry. Yeah, but Buddha had the leg game, didn't he? Done a lot of walking. Yes, Rufus, she's certainly of the equine aesthetic. I think it's fair enough to say that. So check this out. It's mind-blowing. It's very short. Hello, King Corona. Good to see you. Yes, John, me too. It's you know, when Orwell said, if you want an image of this, I'm paraphrasing. If you want an image, you come back from Twitch. It's a bit quiet over there, isn't it? But you know, they send me 60 quid every 6 months, and I'm like, all right, okay, nice. Orwell said something like, if you want an image of the future, it's a boot treading on a human face forever, something like that. But as I always say, now, don't get me wrong, I love Orwell. The Road to Wigan Pier is a better novel than 1984, though, but it's only subjective, isn't it? But The Road to Wigan Pier, working people had it rough back then. It is rough. Steve Perkins says, she gives me the horn. Well, you know, whatever floats your boat. Yeah. What I always say about 1984, out of the two dystopian novels, 1984 is too bleak. It's too obvious in its bleakness. You know, there's people in control, 2 minutes of hate. You must believe 2 + 2 = 5, pulling out teeth. And I get it, and it's a fantastic novel, but Brave New World nails it, because Brave New World, everything's all right. We're fucked. Everything's fucked. But, you know, everything's great. It's a brave new world. And this little, 5 second clip, if that, half a second, sums that up. So have a look at this. The New Zealand PM scaring children. All right, let me just make sure we've got volume. Check it, people. Listen to what she says and look how she says it.
It's actually really straightforward. If you've got a vaccine pass, you can do everything. Basically, that's it. It's actually really straightforward. If you've got a vaccine pass, you can do everything. Basically, that's it. It's actually really straightforward. If you've got a vaccine pass, you can do everything. Basically, that's it. It's actually really straightforward. If you've got a vaccine pass, you can do everything. Basically, that's it. It's actually really straightforward. If you've got a vaccine pass, you can do everything. Basically, that's it. It's actually really straightforward. If you've got a vaccine pass, you can do everything. Basically, that's it. It's actually really straightforward. If you've got a vaccine pass, you can do everything. Basically, that's it.
Now, apologies. I intentionally played that over and over because it's terrifying. Yes, Isaac, it's absolutely creepy. And a new scrubism is born. It's creepy, man. It's really, really, yeah. Yeah, hello, Mr. MF. Good to see you. It's horrible. it's actually very simple. Do what you're fucking told, and you can do what's left. It's actually very simple. 100% compliance to your government, and that's it. It's actually very simple. We own your body. That's it. It's actually very simple. We'll be holding your children down and injecting them while you're being held by police. It's horrific, and that's it. It's actually very simple. We're really, really dangerous people. King Corona, it would appear that your messages are showing. I don't know if... Yes. Not a care in the world. Do you think the likes of her will have a Christmas with her family? Do you think the likes of her will be sitting around on her own? Nah. I mean, and I'll tell you what I will say, which has really, really inspired me. The amount of people who are calling these people what they are, communists and Marxists, is everywhere. And I'm glad about that. I was really pushing that a couple of weeks ago. They're communists. This is all straight out of the communist playbook. All of it. Everything. And I don't think we should ever... yeah, there you go. Be happy, own nothing, have no thoughts. It's actually really very simple. Yeah, we know it's simple, but that it doesn't mean it's right. Simple and right are not the same things. Hello, Duck Boy Jiden. Nice to see you. It's so lovely to see, you know, even what I'd usually have known called centrist news, you know, calling them communist, calling them Marxists. It's great. It's great. There's no more escaping it. And there's one major difference. One second. Darling, don't clean that though. I'll do it. Yeah. Yeah, it's my mess.
Ready?
Whenever you're ready. Sorry, I was asking her not to do the washing up because it's my mess. And trying to hint that she could do it if she wants.
Can I have some?
Huh? Okay. We've got the internet. Hello, Mr. Natras. Good to see you. Yeah, they're being called out for what they are, and it's absolutely lovely. John calls it the satanic New World Order. Oh, God, you're putting the older... you're putting the chills up me with that hard talk, Johnny boy. You know what, Zeitgeist? I didn't even know that, but... I'm not in the least bit surprised. They're communists. These people are communists. That's why they do all this stuff. I mean, this isn't surprising, is it? Who's surprised by what they're doing? And yet, that's why the video is called what it is, because we got the internet now. And I urge you, sorry, people, I've got to put a bit of the old white tiger balm on because I'm being... eaten alive. They're after that pure blood. Surely they can't get me for that. You know, the censorship we've experienced over the last few years, the cancellations we've experienced over the last few years. Yeah, this has all been done before. It's almost been done in this order as well. First of all, shut them up verbally. Then physically remove them from society. It's, you know, hello, love. No, that's not appropriate. They can see in the mirror.
Let's see.
Just stop it. I'm trying to concentrate.
Yeah,
give me that and you can sit down. Sorry, people. You want to eat what? Hot dog.
Not see.
No, but I can see. It's putting me off. Yes, Ian, and they're all over the country. Although I did see a lot of people sending around a Nick Griffin picture saying these are people in Austria. That photo was from a Megadeth or Metallica concert in Moscow from years ago.
You're not
late? No. Shush. Sorry, people. It's a bit difficult because she literally arrived as soon as I started streaming. I haven't seen her in a long while. And now she's playing with the light. Kids, eh? What? You spam, Lady Cecil. I thought you weren't. How does Tiger Balm help with flatulence? Is it for external use only? Well, I've used it as a lubricant to get a couple of ounces of meth up there, and that was cold. It was cold. It was chilly. Hello, Shellbobs. Hello, Wolfie. Hello, Kevin. Hello, Andy. Hey, Shellbobs says hello. Shellbobs says hello.
Hello, Shellbobs.
There you go. There you go. Look at the political prisoners we have in the US over the insurrection. Held in solitary for months. It's unfathomable. It's unfathomable, Mr. MF. I'm with you. Until you think, well, hang on, there's a communist administration in power. And then it's not unfathomable. People disappear in communism. Vans pull up. People get chucked in the back. And you don't see them again. No, she's great stuff. This is how it works. And there'll be more of it. However, look at the numbers. Look at the mainstream media. Go and see the viewing figures for the BBC. Go and see the viewing figures for ITV. Go and see the viewing figures for CNN, MSNBC. Compare them to 15 years ago. Look at someone like Salty Cracker, who is without doubt our guy. You know, he has to play a particular game, but he's live streaming to sort of 30, 40,000 people. Think of Ricatta Law, who are all pro justice and pro Carl Rittenhouse. They had 120,000 people watching live. These are blokes and women in rooms. This is just like me. I got an 80 quid camera, a computer that's on its ass, and you know, I'll stream 250, 200 on the afternoon stream daily. Now, times that by 100,000 people, more than that, you know, millions of small channels that are speaking sense and truth all around the world. We're in a very different situation. I've said it before, but if the internet was 20 years late, we'd be in real trouble, but we're not. What is happening now, I think, is going to ignite the touch paper, and it's going to go off. People are just not having it. People aren't going to have it. How are they going to? Aramas, CNN couldn't even pronounce Waukesha correctly. People are just going to be like, no. How are they going to enforce mandatory vaccinations? How, in Austria, you have it and that's it. How? What, you're going to lock them up? How many people are you going to lock up? I'll be very interested to see how this plays out. Nice one, Zeitgeist. Sent that comrade's vid link to your email. All right, nice one. I'll grab hold of it. I'm really optimistic at the moment. I'm really optimistic because, you know, the world is changing its mind. Right, Zeitgeist, is there a particular moment where I can see her, or is it just the whole thing? Oh, that's her talking, is it? Okay, I'll start about there. Oh, hang on, there's a comrade count. Well, it's a 7-minute video, but I'll start at the beginning. We'll watch a little bit of it. Give me a second, people. Oi, be quiet. That is the optimism that burns through my soul. Thank you for that, Zeitgeist. This looks very funny. So this is her. This is old horse mouth commie south. From when? When was this? Let's see. Jacinda Ardern uses the word comrade 15 times in 7 minutes. This is Allsface tyrannist that we equine. Oh, there's got to be a better one. My missus is trying to work out how to turn my big light on and blow me off the face of the earth. Like, she's really looking around it. No! right, let's have a look at this. This is her. This is that bird we just see. Not that bird that you just see who's prancing around because she's an exhibitionist. Hello, Jays. I think there's someone over there with you. Right, let's have a listen to the woman who is a communist. Sorry, people. I am a little bit... You know, I've had a lot of hard work going on this morning, and like I say, my missus just arrived. Don't worry, the stream will start soon. Trotterski. Hello, Mark. Trotterski. Right, let's hear it. Let me know you've got audio, eh? But there's a comrade count.
I cannot say anything until I first say a word of thanks to the Prime Minister of Hungary for being with us here today, to our comrades, the party leader, and to our hosts, our organisers, our comrades, Societas. Give it up again for Societas!
When she thanks the Prime Minister of Hungary to be there, I'm guessing it's not Orban.
And comrades, I must also thank your political leaders for this UC Festival 2009. Not only the Secretariat, who have done a fantastic job, but our UC Presidium, who stand behind me and who have led the political program and assisted with the organization of this festival, and also to the UC Secretary General, Johan Hassel. Please, one more time, give it up for them.
Good call, John.
Comrades, as we leave this festival, I'm reminded of...
You get the idea. She's a communist. And, you know, what they do, Mark mentioned Trotsky. This is what they do. Trotsky's big thing, well, was his moustache. Trotsky's big thing was the ice pick in his head. Sorry. Trotsky's big thing was entryism. So in the Long March, these people, they get their Marxist study. They read all their books. They think this is how to do it. They blame society for their own failings. And what better remedy than communism? What? It's the world who's at fault, not me. Oh, it's the world's fault that I don't feel good about myself. Is that what you're saying? Fucking wicked. I mean, and that works for teenagers, teenage angst. Communism feeds on teenage angst. It sort of, you know, eats it up. It loves it. And vice versa. Teenage angst feeds on communism. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's not my fault. It's not me. It's not my fault that I'm not going to achieve anything. It's not my fault that I've got no motivation. It's not my fault that I'm an arsehole. It's the world's fault. What have we got to do? Oh, we've got to destroy it all. Okay, nice one, comrade. And then they get a bit older and people are like, yeah, keep the old comrade stuff down, yeah? Just pretend you're nice, liberal, yeah, love minorities, yeah, free stuff. Just think free stuff. You're going to give out free stuff. That's how you get in power. And then when you're in power, just fucking turn into authoritarian communists and just tuck the bodies away somewhere. Hello, Dawn Browning. How are you? Lovely to see you. Scorry, hello, mate. Morning, friends. Thank you, Scorry. That's Machano Capricia TT 100%. Nice one. Who said politics is showbiz for ugly people? I don't know who said it, but that's bang on. Gaffney nails it. Those teenagers are now university professors brainwashing entire generations with this virus. Yeah, figuratively and literally. Yeah. And the banking. I can't believe she's bought food and I'm streaming. You got prawn?
No.
Okay. Didn't buy me anything. That Kajikistan woman who was trained in Moscow and wrote her thesis. What's her name? Moronova or something? That Biden's put forward as comptroller of the currency. Oh, yeah, she wants to nationalize banking in the US. That's communism. It's what all the people say. You want some money, we're going to give it all away. Yeah, this is, and it's great that they're being called out for this. This, you know, control of language is a really important thing. And don't let these people be called Democrats. Don't let them be called liberals. Call them what they are. Communists, Marxists. Trevor, hello, Trevor. Is that Golk? You can't tell between an L and an I. I'm going to guess it's Golk. Trevor's better, isn't it? Communism always seems to end up in starvation and genocide. Yeah, every single time. Yeah. And you all know why. Because with no free markets, you don't know the value of your resources. You can't plan. That's why. It can't work. With no free markets to regulate value, you can't value your resources. If you can't value your resources, you can't plan. That's why everyone dies of starvation and then torture. And it's weird that the really funny thing is that They almost want the starvation. They almost want a culling. Because if you cull a major part of your population, you know, you've got less people to give free stuff to. And I mean that. I really mean that. Nice one, Matt. Pew. Get yourself some takeout too. I damn will do. I am Hank Marvin, I'll tell you that. I did have some jackfruit before we started, but I'll tell you what, Matt, I'll tell you what that'll go on, Matt, sort of, symbolically, because I won't get access to that for about a month. But I will, I'll go and get some Galan in a bit, and I'll think of you. Thank you, though, Matt. That's Machano Capruccia Tutu. Really is. Dawn Browning! Dawn Browning! 12 and over can't have their picks with Unsupermarket Santa. Unsupermarket. I quite like that. Can't have their picks with Unsupermarket Santa until they're jabbed. Great. How do they know Santa's at it? thank you, Dawn. I mean, that's shocking, isn't it? Mum, can we go and see Santa? No, no. You know. Bearsworth says, all you talk about is bullshit fucking left-right paradigm, bullshit what a fucking joke, serious. Are you drunk or can you just not write? Don't know. How many videos of mine have you watched? Because when I'm doing 4 hours a day, every day, I'd suggest that the amount of what you call bullshit fucking left-right paradigm, bullshit fucking joke serious, probably makes up for about 15% of what I talk about. So not only are you unable to articulate yourself in a sophisticated and adult manner, you're also wrong. Which is quite embarrassing. Feel free, Rags. I mean, there's, you know, by, let me see. Well, that's life. That's life. It's what all the people say. Hello, Mr. Bastard. How are you? Nice to see you. Oh, that's a tune, isn't it? Clever Trevor. It, so many good tunes from Ian Dury. Billericky Dicky, Clever Trevor, Sex, Drugs and Rock and Roll, Hit Me With My Rhythm Stick. I think my favourite has got to be Wake Up, Make Love to Me. Wake Up, Make Love. What a tune that is. Absolutely amazing. What's the Galanja like over there? What's Galanja? I don't know what, I don't even know what that is. I don't really know what that is. I agree with you on that, Zeitgeist, and that's why I don't want them to put all the private banking into the Fed. That seems like a ridiculous idea. Get your Galan. Hey! Well, I tried to give her the call. What was it? Yeah, the gallon there, the $1 there, the gallon there. Yeah, the $1 there, the gallon there. And she's got her own Kamai version. Yeah, let's see if I can get to do it. Darling, do your gallon call. Go on, loud. Come on. Come on. Come on. Last chance. She's got it. The only Cockney market trader in Phnom Penh. Oi, bong there the moi de galan bong. Moi goi de moi de galan bong. Yeah, hopefully Grego. It's usually 90% shoes and clothes. I mean, it's ridiculous. Just another angry drunk. Hello, Foot Golf, how are you? Yeah, It's, no, Alex is one of about, he's about number 30. Last Reaper says, afternoon danger, don't listen to that twat. You have your finger on the pulse. Unfortunately, not mine. Nice one, Lost Reaper. I'm all right. Water off a duck's back. It's just gone. Neil Toner. That's an amazing name. I like it. Neil Toner. Neil Toner. Neil Toner. I don't know why I got so into it. It's weird as well, because when you have to change the toner in a photocopy, you have to kneel. Wrong is the new right. You're not far off as well. I don't know, Isaac. I don't know. I mean, it's nice to have new people, and I'm all out. I'm all up for being challenged. Nice to be challenged. Sometimes you're wrong, and you learn something. But I'm not going to waste time debating with fuck bum willy willy bum fuck bum willy. No. Space Opera Mark loves left right waffle. Yeah, all right. Yeah, thank you, Jake. Right, so what's the weed like out here? Did I, have I not shown, did, is that what you meant? You meant weed, did you? Did you confirm you meant the cannabis? Right, okay. Well, you can have it. You're allowed to grow it. No one minds. I'll show you mine again. You can buy that. You can smoke it in the streets. You can just smoke. You can smoke it in bars. Just light up a biff, and no one cares. You know, why would anyone worry about that? It's almost weird to be sensible, isn't it? Yeah, you can buy very high quality stuff here. The local gear is quite good as well. Yeah, the outdoor gear is pretty good. I'll show you what I grew a couple of years ago. I'm going to get a load more on this. I don't smoke it anymore. I smoked one bifter of my what I grew, and I just went, nah, it's too strong for me. And that was the end of my... Oh, actually, I did have a bifter with the gin the other night. Are you still rabbiting? Do you want me to show her? This is my girlfriend's breakfast. I mean, that's a healthy diet right there. I didn't say right there. Right there? So, yeah, you can buy concentrates and all that. There's a cafe that just sells them. It's the old Amsterdam thing. You go in there. There's a couple of them. And they've got a menu and you order it. You can get pre-rolls. You can get dabs. You can get all that. You know, it's all right. It's all right. But I'll show you what I grew because the climate is perfect for it. This was one of mine. What else have I got? This was one of mine. This was amazing. That was the amnesia haze. Look at the THC. That's not ripe. That was about a week away from being ripe. But they're just auto flowers chucked in a pot, a bit of back guano. Bob's your uncle. I did use a bit of recharge. That was them at about 2 weeks. And I'll show you the actual product. That's a cured, trimmed bud. So in answer to your question, yeah, all right. It's fucking great out here. I agree, John. I think very underrated as well. That's right. The classic line, Zeitgeist, is the Federal Bank is as federal as Federal Express. But I'll tell you what, how this might be interesting. With this year's harvest, I'll get on the old phone for the start of the stream and I'll show you how they're developing because it's easy as piss. It's easy. And those auto flowers, they go from seed to harvest in like 10 or 11 weeks. Beautiful. I bet I've got all those stay eyes absolutely frothing at the moot. Hello, Vespa Check. Good to see you. I am so Kajetl says, dislike button actually gone now. Has it actually gone? I wouldn't be surprised, because I was watching Salty Cracker on Odyssey the other day, and along the top of Odyssey, it said, we have a dislike button. Has it actually gone? Well, I can still see it on my YouTube version, but they are talking about getting rid of it. If it's a... Matt, if it's a commercial operation, they don't like it. But there's shops where you can just go in and buy it. They've got better things to do than worry about people smoking a bit of weed. Cambodia is part of Cambodian culture. They've been growing out here for centuries. It's used in cooking. That's why, you know, you can grow a few plants. Hello, love. More food? Not for me, but not for me. Right, I think I've got... Hello, Moslab. Good to see you. You've been out firing those new weapons. I think it was Gaffney actually sent me a picture of... It looks like an AR-15, but it fires 50 cal rounds. I can't remember what it was called. It's called something like a beer moth or something. Someone might... You like a bit of that? They were good. Good. Not. I'm not a bad. I've been growing weed though since '92, so I was in early, and I really love growing it. But like I said, I got about 13 ounces. I gave it all away. I had that one biffed, and I just went, I've got to go to bed. Fuck this. Me and her had one night. I tell you a funny story for a girl who never smoked weed, right? Yeah, man, the bud father. If you're into smoking weed and growing it, a very good channel is called the Dude Grows channel. Dude Grows. If you search Dude Grows, they stream every day and they talk about growing weed every day. And they're a nice couple of blokes as well. But listen to this, right? So when I had all that amnesia haze, and we had some 24 carat, which was just stupid, 100% indica, it's like later. And me and the missus went out and had a few gins, and we came home, and I said to her, do you want to smoke a bit of that plant? She calls it my plant, because I've just got to go out and look at my plant. So she thinks it's called my plant, but I don't bother correcting it because it's funny. And so I said to her, oi, darling, remember when you smoked my plant?
Oui.
Listen to this. It's a real funny first stoner. So we sat out. It was when I was living upstairs. So we sat out on the porch, and I put this little biff together, and we're quite drunk. We've only had like 3 or 4 gins, but she only weighs about 4 kilos. So I put this little biff together, and I'm sitting there, and I'm thinking, this is too strong, man. This is too strong. I am fucked. And I've given it to her. She's never even smoked a cigarette. And so she's going. She had about 4 tokes, which was a lot. There was no tobacco in it. It was pure amnesia haze, right? And then she went, I said, darling, I've got to lay down. I am fucked. And she went, no, nothing. Nothing. And I went, yeah, all right, I've got to lay down. we come back in the house, and I'm just like looking for the bed, and then I turn around, and honestly, she's got pontoon eyes, one's twisting, the other's sticking, and she just falls on the bed, gone. They're the future. For me, it's all about auto flowers. You know, they're great. They're great. They, you know, because the veg period is about a week, you know, even if you get spider mites, it doesn't really matter, because they're not in the pot for very long. You know, you can deal with pests and problems. They're very hardy against pests and problems. And this is interesting. Some people are saying, I can see the dislike button. Scorry has not seen it in over a week. Zeitgeist says I still got it. Broken Silence says it's still here, but no number. I mean, you know, there you go. It's called Beowulf. It's like an AR-15 that fires 50 cal rounds. Good Lord. Isn't it weird? So King Corona says the dislike button is there, but you can't see the number. More communism. We're all the same. Everything's good. Brave new world. Yeah, look, I've got 1,000 likes. How many dislikes? None. What, everyone liked it? No, but who cares about reality? You can't judge people. You can't dislike something. It might upset them. That's what it's about. That's what that's about. Now, look at what it actually does for YouTube. Someone builds a channel and they come on and they go, hello, I've got no balls. Come and have a look at my lead. Come and have a look at my Lego. And it's shit, right? It's shit. And so everyone's like, shit. This is shit. 1,000 dislikes. When the geezer that made the video has a look at his likes, dislikes, he goes, oh, dear. 2 likes, 1,000 dislikes. Well, I won't make any more of that content then because it's not worth it. People don't like it. A good thing for YouTube, a good thing for society. How about we elevate things that are good? And how about we let people know when it's not good? But, oh, no, it would appear not anymore. What's the point of a dislike that you can't see? There's no point to it. This is participation medals. This is participation medals. You can't dislike something. Nice one, Carlson. You and your missus both have wireless headphones. Yeah, but I've got Apple AirPods and I bought her a pair of Snides for 14 quid off of eBay. I don't think she knows. Oh, look at that. Her name is Beowulf. Did you give her a good cleaning? Oh, I'll tell you what, I had a mate and he once, Carlson, thanks for the donation. The grift has been all right actually today, I have to say. I had a mate and I said to him once, I said, do you want to come around mine, weirdly, to smoke some weed? We were only teenagers. And he went, no, I've got to bathe the dog. Oh, thank you, Carlson. Thank you. Her name is Beowulf. Thank you, Keys to the Kingdom. He said the dislike is good. He hit it twice. I mean, maybe I can see in the analytics that you've got bad ones. Mark says, I still watch the TGC, the dude grows. TDC? I can't. I know the channel you're talking about. Yeah, great stuff, because this fella here does a bit of gardening. We helped each other out. I got him onto the auto flowers. But you still get a bit busy with the others, don't you? I'm all over the autos. I don't even smoke the bloody stuff. But I did have one the other day with a bit of gin. Hello, Arklow Rocks. Good to talk to you the other day, mate. Field Marshal Browning. I disliked my last YouTube video because dislike lives matter. Dislike lives matter. Don't dislike your own videos. I watch all of them. Nice one, Dawn. No, they're not. That's a myth. That's a myth. They were a couple of years ago, but the speed of the development. Go to the auto, I think it's called the Auto Flower Network, AFN, forum. You know, but think about it like this, Ian. 11 weeks from seed to flower. So if you get a shit yield, you know, if you're going usual plants, you're looking at what, 4 months, 5 months? Fuck that. You know, you could grow, out here, you could grow 5 auto flowers in that time. So look at the yields like that. Anyway, this is becoming a grow channel. Welcome to Dangerfield Grows. I would suggest people, if you're interested, you know, you can grow auto flowers outdoors in England. I'm all about outdoors as well. I'm not into growing under artificial lights. It's all about the sunshine. I mean, would you want to eat all your food that was grown indoors? Would you want a cucumber that had never seen any sunlight? Nah, something wrong with that. Thank you, Dawn, for the donation. Windy says people are testing the dislike. Lovely. What a time to do it. Yeah, and well, this is it, Kajetel. You know, the Young Turks, their live streams, everyone's hate watching it. They just get ratioed. But there'll be no more ratios, you know. It's a lie. It's a lie. Now we have no reality. Jemima Saliva says that she sees two dislikes. Yeah, of course. This is it. I mean, Joe Biden done a live stream, and I think they had 16 people watching it. 16. I mean, Jimmy gets more than that. Yeah, it was really good to talk to you. I'm going to do a call in, I think, every weekend. They're really good. All super happy fun. Yeah. It is the same. Marzipan retired. Used to grow amazing tomato plants. Make me own hash, rosin, and RSO. Bullshit. Yeah, I don't know about Rick Simpson oil. It's a lot of palaver. These days, you can just get a press, chuck your flowers in it, press a button, and it all... I told Mark how to make that. Mark, how did I get you onto that? Mark made some rosin. Live rosin. I can't remember how we'd done it, though. I think it might have just been a clamp or something. No. Hair tongs, Ma. Hair tongs. You know, like the hot tongs for your hair that you grip and you hair straighteners. Yeah, bit of greaseproof paper, sorry. Put your flour in it. It just all dribbles out. But, you know, flour, terpenes, CBD. Yeah, you don't need that. This is not a grow channel. But auto flowers, you plant them. They veg grow for a week and you don't need a light cycle change. They just automatically change into flowering in a week. Quite something. Yep, that is the downside. If you have a unicorn that is just the best bud ever. However, there are people who are doing that. There are people who are now managing to do it, but it's a lot of fiddling about and, you know. Anyway, see you later, Steve. Take care, mate. Unless you were talking about something else. Yeah, it's a completely different game indoors, but I prefer the sun. I mean, when I first started growing, we were using HIDs, and then you had to change the bulb for flowering. I mean, fuck me. What was that, 30 years ago? Remember? Exactly, Grego. Exactly. Scory reckons 16 people were watching the most popular president ever were hate watching. Yeah, I must admit, the cheaper LEDs ain't all that. They're not great. Right, no more grow talk. Well, okay. If you don't like them, Ian, that's no problem. Crack on with whatever you want to do. Yes, that's where I got my seeds from. Yeah, Mephisto. Yeah, exactly where I got my autoflower seeds from. They're amazing. John, if you're interested, this is the end of the grow section of this grow channel. If you're interested, their 24 carat is fucking ridiculous. It's ridiculous. They're pricey, though. You pay for them. But, yeah, Mephisto Genetics, they're called, aren't they? That's where I got my seeds. Anyway, no more. The Danger Grows channel. I could do it, though. I've been growing on and off for, like, 30 years. But anyway, I've got something I want to show you. It's today's toxic masculinity section. And I've discovered my new favorite YouTuber. So it's not street beefs today. This is, we saw him on yesterday's channel where he was doing a review of Mikhail Welbeck's book Platform. He reviews books, but he doesn't. It's almost extreme not gonzo book reviews, which I like. He does take a bit of getting used to, I'll give him that. But in this review, and this is today's toxic masculinity section, he's reviewing Hegel's Phenomenology of the Spirit. Okay, now it's 4 minutes, and it's not going to be everyone's cup of tea. But he's, oh, you like this fella, do you, John, or you like the Grow Talk? So this is the book club. The bloke whose channel it is called Quentin. I've already emailed him to ask if he wants to come on the channel. I'd imagine he won't because he's an arrogant little shit, but he might do. And this is today's toxic masculinity. And he's reviewing Hegel's Phenomenology of Spirit. He's a funny bloke. Remember, people, that his channel is called The Book Club, and this is his review of Hegel's Phenomenology of the Spirit. Bear that in mind while you're watching it. Oh, you watched some more, did you, Hayden? Yeah, I'm really into it. I mean, as far as book reviews go, it's pretty good, isn't it? What are you getting from Hegel's Phenomenology of the Spirit so far?
Howdy, stranger. Our story begins right over yonder.
Could you delete this?
Hey, Andy, come over here and polygamy.
You not film right now? I'm trying to take a wee jobby. I'm doing a wee jobby in the nude.
And that is today's toxic masculinity. It's a review of Hegel's Phenomenology of Spirit. I'm going to try and get him on. He's a very, very funny bloke. Marzipan says, have a lady for your rubbish advice. We'll agree to disagree. The thing is, though, Ian, that's very kind of you. The thing is, this is a big debate in the growing world at the moment. This is what everyone's talking about. If you watch a Dude Grows channel, this is what the big debate is. Auto flowers don't grow enough. Auto flowers aren't strong enough. And this is what it's all about. So, you know, the truth is, what suits you? What do you need? What is your expenditure? What setup have you got? Are you growing inside or outside, etc., etc.? And one of those two options will suit you better. I think that's what it comes down to. Yeah, Hayden, I've watched loads of his videos, and like I say, I've written to him. I think he'd make a great guest. Mozlab, who continually moans about almost every animal in America, including crocodiles. I think he said they're fucking pests. Maybe it was alligators. He wants to know, Dawn, whether kangaroos destroy gardens. Are kangaroos a garden pest? Thank you, Ian. No, all growing swords aside, that's a very kind donation. Yeah, I struggled with it, Isaac. I mean, I read Phenomenology of the Mind, and read in as much as I read the words. Yeah, it's very difficult. I mean, I'm negating negations until I'm all out of negations. You know, it's not easy. Anyone here read? Honestly, John, I could have picked a better one, actually. I'll show you like 1 second. I'll show you 20 seconds of his review of Adorno's Minimum Moralia, which is one of my, dare I say, favourite books. I'll show you just a little bit. Let me find it. Hang on, people. 1 second. It'd be a really interesting bloke to get on the channel. He really would be. Where's his minimum right? This is called Theodore 100% not gay, Adorno, Minimum Moralia. I've cut out a bit of the intro, but this is his review of Minimum Moralia, which is a book of aphorisms and short passages by Adorno. I won't play a lot of it. I know it's not everyone's cup of tea, but I think he's quite an engaging bloke myself. That's actually him on the saxophone, by the way. What an amazing book club channel.
What's up, my white supremacists and white supremacist allies? I'm the gay shaman Q, and you're watching the worst book review channel on YouTube. Totalitarianism and homosexuality belong together, and for this reason, my friends, I would like to propose that we make Theodore Adorno our homo fascist of the month.
You get the idea. I'm trying to get him on. Let's hope he agrees. There you go. I'll put a link into the chat. It's very good stuff, Bless him. Funny little bloke. I don't think he'll like to hear me call him a funny little bloke. There you go. I've just put a link to that video in the channel, so you'll be able to find it. It's called The Book Club. That's what his channel's called. He's got about 20,000 subs, though. People tend to like his videos. Good lad. Interesting lad. Yeah, no problem. Hello, Bearing. You can't overcook Kang. You can't overcook Kanga. It gets very tough. But is it a garden pest, though, Bearing? Does it eat stuff in your garden? How many kangaroos have you seen, Bearing? How many kangaroos have you seen, Dawn? I mean, in England, we get the idea that they're like foxes. They're like always about pissing everywhere. But are they quite rare to see? Mozlab wants to know if there's a hunting season for kangaroos. There seems to be a lot of them running around. Yeah, that's what I just said. But I reckon they're quite rare. I reckon they're probably quite rare if you undercook them. Here we go. Hello, Tim. Nice to see you. Nice to see you. Aramas is having flashbacks to his theology degree. Yeah, but he's quite good at taking the piss, though, that fellow. There's nothing very serious in it. But, you know, there you go. Oh, my days. Flipping hundreds, but not in suburbia. So they're quite common, are they? Okay. Yes, my love?
I love you.
Okay. It's nice to know. Me too. Matt says, if they're like deer in Northern Australia, Narcotics Anonymous, they're everywhere. Zeitgeist says, not rare here in Australia. Bearing says, in my area, they are like foxes. I nearly ran one over the other day on the way to the Splendid Market. Bearing, do you have a kangaroo fixing on the front of your vehicle? North America, good Lord. I've showed myself up to be stupid. I don't know. Yeah, it's good stuff, Aramath. It's a good old channel. A good channel. Right, I've got something else to show you. I just haven't got it rigged up. Hang on. Where is it? Oh, not that. I can't show that. Where is it? I think I'm absolutely lying. Oh, man, this is worth a watch. We'll have a little look at this. I know this isn't my content, but fuck me, this is shocking. Absolutely shocking and absolutely sus. This is Salty Cracker talking about, well, I'll let you see for yourself. Check this out, people. Mind blowing. So some leftist who worked for the Democrats. She actually worked for a local Democrat party, right? And I think she was their social media person. And she suggested that the Wisconsin Christmas car deaths were karma, because Carl Rittenhouse was found not guilty. She actually said it was karma. Oh, and then she lost her job. Let's see what the king of the top of the Christmas tree is. Salty Cracker's got to say about it. Over 50 million kangas in Australia. Good Lord.
Holy balls. Do you want to see instant regret? Do you want to see somebody go from, Lulz, take that. Take that, you white people. I'm glad you got killed at a Christmas parade. In a holiday. Now they're calling it Christmas. They don't ever want to say Christmas. Now they definitely want to say Christmas. Take that. You Easter worshippers getting killed. Lulz, this is what you get. For freeing that who white supremacist domestic terrorist Kyle Rittenhouse to immediately go, Reese Thurman!
Oh, and while we're there, can we just acknowledge that some absolute shit fart described Kyle Rittenhouse as that little white supremacist? What a shitty thing to say. Well, anyway, this one here, this absolute fucktard got what she had coming to her. Check it. Talk about karma, the irony.
Stop sending me tweets. I'm going to kill myself. Do you want to see that? Because that just happened. I mean, holy shit. Take a look at this. What a fucking mess. This entire Waukesha tragedy.
Actually, she is Gaffney, and you know, I don't, you know, my thoughts on that, but she is, and that, you know, that has to be acknowledged. I think
it could be blamed on Joy Reid, right? If we can blame Alex Jones, if Alex Jones can be sued by those totally not an Operation Sandy Hook families over his audience sending mean tweets and harassing them, then I imagine the Waukesha victims should be able to sue Joyless Reid, MSNBC, Joe Biden, VP, all these other people who jumped in on the Kyle Rittenhouse situation.
And I'm sure many of you watched the Tucker Carlson, Kyle Rittenhouse interview. What a lovely lad he is. And of course, first thing out is, oh, I noticed he didn't cry when he was talking about it to Tucker. Yeah, because his life wasn't on the line. He hadn't been in prison for 87 days. He's out. He's free. It's a slightly different situation. But no, just keep piling it on that really, really lovely kid. What a fantastic job his parents have done of raising him. He's just an absolute symbol of, I'd be proud as punch if he was my kid. And now they're all the cunting leftards are shitting on him from all angles, including this one. Oh, but it come back and slapped her right in the boat race.
And said that was an affront to justice. It was a tragedy. And now black people are going to be killed. And then, you know, 2 days later, you get a black dude running through a parade full of white people. And then all the lefties celebrate, by the way. All of these trash bag pieces of shit who, again, at least they're being consistent. They're constantly siding with terrorists and kid fuckers lately. When you blow up Soleimani, the second in command in Iran, these lefties were like, oh my God, I can't believe it. I want to stand up for the dude who's funding Hamas. I'm like, oh shit, that's weird. When you blow up the leader of ISIS, they go, hey, I can't believe you killed our austere leader over here. Again, you're siding with terrorists? That's a bold strategy.
Yeah, I'm not sure if you remember that, but I'm probably sure most of you didn't forget it. When they killed that ISIS leader, the New York Times described him in his obituary as an austere leader. He's a fucking terrorist. Are you people mental? Oh, no, you're not mental. Worse, you're communists. Continue.
And then, of course, their newest hero is a kid fucker. And now they're over there stumping for this guy who ran through this parade over here. We're now finding out that not only was his rap sheet 8 miles long, but part of his rap sheet was he was trafficking a 16-year-old between California and Nevada. Holy fuck. The amount of kid fuckers on this is what you think. There's some sort of deep global conspiracy of kid fuckers on the Democrat Party side. Yeah, of course. It's not that secret, obviously. But anyway, here's one of these trash bag humans. Democrat operative came out and she was like, lols, you deserve that. Stupid white people in Wisconsin, you deserve it. And then immediately said, please stop.
And that's exactly what happened. So she said, she tweeted loads of tweets that it was karma and, you know, just, and she works for the Democrats. She doesn't anymore because it come back and slapped her in the face. Funny how karma actually works.
Illinois Dem blasted for calling Wisconsin Christmas Rampage karma. And she deleted her tweet. But we'll have it over here. So it was probably just self-defense, Lemansky wrote in a tweet that appears to have since been deleted. Yeah. Oh, yeah. She definitely deleted it.
Can you believe that? Can you believe that geezer rammed through a load of people, killing five? And she tweeted it was probably just self-defense. Now, look, I think she should be allowed to say that. But, oh, you try coming at that from another angle. You try coming at that from... I don't know, the right. No, you're banned immediately. Well, she had to delete her own tweets, but check out what happened to her.
Try to walk this shit back. Quote, living in Wisconsin, he probably felt threatened, another tweet. See, she was all in.
She's actually said that about the geezer that plowed through all those people. Living in Wisconsin, he probably felt threatened. The geezer was a career criminal. I mean, ignore that. He probably felt threatened. What? Hang on. The kid that was threatened was Carl Rittenhouse. No one who didn't attack him is dead or shot. No one. Ridiculous. These people are sick. Oh, no, they're not. They're communists. Sorry. I keep forgetting.
Emboldened for a while there, sending out a lot of tweets. Take that, you fucking white people. You deserve it. Hashtag BLM. And fuck cops, by the way. Defund all the fucking cops. Glad you white motherfuckers are being run over. Wow, it's weird. It's a weird point to have over here. This one's still up on Monday morning, by the way. Says, quote, I'm sure he didn't want to hurt anyone. He came to help. Lols. See what she did there? Lols. See, the car is just like a Pixar movie, and it felt threatened by white people holding a Christmas parade because, of course, Christmas is colonization.
Now, this is interesting because I hear this a lot, and, you know, I don't talk about this a hell of a lot, but I'd suggest, Carlson, reading Karl Marx's essay on the Jewish question. Very interesting, because I think you'll probably be a little bit surprised. I'm not saying that means what you're saying isn't necessarily true, but the whole communist and the tribe is always there's many contradictions in there.
Of white supremacy. And so the car just drove through. No. You've got a black supremacist who drove through a bunch of white people. Right? And again, that's the side that you're picking. A Democrat operative, by the way. So, I mean, look at this platform. She wants to defund the police. She wants to disarm citizens. And she's totally stoked when black supremacists run over non-black people. I'd be concerned with this person in any type of political position of power. We ain't giving up no guns, by the way. Holy hell no. So then after she gets blasted, she goes, quote, I said, like, anytime anyone dies, I just believe karma. And this time it came around quick to the citizens of Wisconsin. Quote, you reap what you sow. And
it said that- It's just shocking. I'm sad when anyone dies, but I just believe in karma. And this time it came around quick. Can you imagine? Can you imagine some of the people that died in that? Bearing in mind she's already made that, it was probably just self-defense. I just believe in karma. And saying that the black people in Wisconsin are scared now. What? There was no race issue in this. It's absolutely barking mad baloney. And thankfully she's lost her job. Fuck off. We all agree with you, of course, but we can't say it so clearly. Madness. Absolute freaking madness. Ah, people. Right. People, I've already put 3 hours grafting in today, so I'm going to leave. Oi. I'm going to leave it at an hour and a half. Very unlikely I'll stream later because my missus has just arrived. Thank you all for coming. Thank everyone who donated. Thank you all for your inga. Exactly. Yeah, that's kind of where I stand, John. But you know, it's a hot subject, isn't it? Maybe one day we'll do a call in about it and just get it out of the way. People, enjoy the rest of your day. Enjoy the rest of your week. It's I don't even know what day it is. Tuesday. I might stream later, but probably not. But I'll certainly see you tomorrow morning. Thank you for Rags and Moz Lab for looking after the place. Thank you all for getting busy in the chat. Thank you all for coming and watching. And have a lovely day. And I'll see, if not later, I'll see you tomorrow morning. Take care, everyone. Look after yourselves. And ta-da! Yeah. Exactly. I haven't even said hello to her properly, King Corona. Well, I wasn't going to say it, Hayden. Not on a Tuesday. Thank you, Hayden. That's much appreciated. It's been appalling.
Everyone knows I'm going to be the first man down. All my friends are sick.
Or has a different opinion. And that's all, another option.
Nobody wants to give a buddy one last breath. Can't go on a take.
There you go. Kajetel's giving you a little tip there.
Life is a curse. It only gets worse in the world. And watch you drown. Maybe my mind will fail to ever find the point. I'm going deep, deep down underwater. Gonna make my grave underneath the waves. I'm going deep, deep down underwater. Gonna lay my head.
Oh, before everyone does the off, at the end of yesterday's stream, just as I turned off the stream, I got a super chat from Tech Roach, and he was like, "Hello, everyone." So that was really nice, and he's building himself back up. So I just want him to come back on and be part of things again, because he's been here forever, and he's one of us. We are us. Continue, Mr. Mumford.
On the riverbed.
Yeah, exactly that, Mars Lab.
Every place I stay.
Nice one, Keys.
A woman says I'm lying in the bed I've made. She says warriors don't give up before the war begins. So I get high to justify the mess I'm in. People get mad, people get sad, but at least they have a call.
Good night,
sweet girl. Emotion,
take care, dog.
I'm going deep, deep down underwater. Gonna make my grave underneath the waves. I'm going deep, deep down underwater. Gonna lay my head on the riverbed.
Nice one, Carlson. Yeah, that's a good one. Tea in the chat for Tech Roach. Cheers, Carlson.
I'm going deep, deep down underwater. Gonna make my grave. I'm going deep, deep down underwater. Gonna lay my head on the riverbed. I'm going deep, deep down underwater. Gonna make my grave underneath the waves. I'm going deep, deep down.
Boom, 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 boom. Enjoy the rest of your day, people. Oh, the sun's going down. I've got to go and get myself some... No, I've got a crumb, a galan. People, I will see you soon. Take care, look after yourselves. And the solution to the problems at the moment is in the problem. Look around, see what's happening, see the response to it. It's the start of something amazing, I'm convinced. Be good.